Today, I'm going to be speedrunning the math calculator section of the SAT practice exam 1. If I fail this exam and I do bad on this speedrun, then Collegeboard is going to find me and take me to their gold mine. So wish me luck. All right, let's go. John runs at different speeds as part of his training program. His heart rate, blah, blah, blah. On which interval is the target heart rate strictly increasing, then strictly decreasing? Strictly increasing means going up, and then decreasing is going down. The only part that's going up and then immediately going down is between 40 and 60, so the answer is B. Number 3, in the figure above, lines L and M are parallel. S and T are parallel. Angle 1 is 35, angle 2. Okay. If angle 1 is 35, where the heck? Angle 1 is 35. This is 35 degrees. This is 180 minus 35, which is 145. This is also 35. This is also 35. So 2 must be 145. 2. If y is equal to kx, where k is constant and y is 24, when x is equal to 6, what is the value of y when x is equal to 5? Okay. Y is equal to k times 6. And then 24 is equal to k times 6. 24 divided by 6 is 4. K is equal to 4. And then y is equal, when x is equal to 5, we have y is equal to 4 times 5, 20. Easy, easy, easy. Okay, question 4. If 16 plus 4 is 10 more than 14, what is the value of 8x? Oh my gosh. 10 more than 14 is 24. 16 plus 4x. 4x is equal to 8. X is equal to 2. 8x is equal to 16. I could have skipped that. Ooh, next page. Which of the following graphs best shows a strong negative association between D and T? Negative association means as one increases, the other decreases. The only one that shows that is D. One decagram is standard. The hospital stores one type of medicine in 2 decagram containers. Based on the information given in the box above, how many 1 milligram doses are there in 1 decagram container? This is a conversion. So a decagram is 10 grams. So 2 decagram is 20 grams. And then 1 milligram, there's 20 times 1,000 to get the milligram conversion, which is 20,000. So that's how many 1 milligram doses there are in 1 decagram counter. That's it for that page. Rooftop solar panel installations in 5 cities. The number of rooftop with solar panel installations in 5 cities is shown in the graph above. The total number of installations is 27,500. What is an appropriate label for the vertical axis of the graph? It's not in tens, and it's not in tens of thousands. If A is 9, it only makes sense if it's in thousands. Can't really have 900 and then have it decreasing. It'll never sum to 27,000. For what value of n is n minus 1 plus 1 absolute value equal to 0? I mean, this is a plug-in, right? Well, the absolute value of n minus 1 is always going to be greater than or equal to 0. So n minus 1 absolute value plus 1 is always going to be greater than or equal to 1. So there is no such n. Nice, thanks. Next page. Oh my gosh, decimals. I'm never going to see my family again. Which of the following expressions, this is the air temperature in terms of the speed of a sound wave. The speed of a sound wave in feet per second, T the air temperature. So we just got to solve for T, basically. Well, T is just A minus 1052 divided by 1.08. It has to be a minus. That's none of these. No minus. And it's A minus it, so it has to be A. At which of the following air temperatures will the speed of sound wave be closest to 1,000 feet per second? Okay, so when is it? When is A equal to 1,000 equal to 1052 plus 1.08T? I don't need the calculator for this one. We're going to subtract 1052 from 1,000. 1,000 minus 1052 is negative 52 is equal to 1.08t. We're solving for t here. We divide negative 52 by 1.08 and we get negative 48.14. That's b. Oops. Hey, this is me in the future. I got this question wrong. So instead of wasting both of our times here, I'm going to skip it and add a minute to a penalty timer that I'll incorporate at the end. Oh man, a table. A group of 10th grade students responded to the survey that asked which math course they currently enrolled in. The survey data were broken down as shown in the table above. 19% of all survey respondents. Okay, there's 310 in total. 10% of that would be 31. 20% of that would be 62. So we're looking for a number close to 62. We have 62 on there, but that's 20%. 19% would be slightly under, so closer to 59, which we do see for males taking geometry. Females taking algebra 2 is closer to 20. Males taking geometry is closer to our target number. And that is correct after doing it on the calculator. The table above lists the lengths to the nearest inch of random sample of 21 brown bullhead fish. The outlier measurement of 24 inches is an error of the mean, median, and range of the values listed, which will change the most if the 24-inch measurement is removed from the data. Well, the range of the data goes from 11 to 16 after this is removed. No, it goes from 8 to 16, which is the size of 8. 8 to 24 is the size of 16, so this is a change in 16. The mean is definitely less than that change in range. The median is still going to be 12, so it's going to be C, range. What does the c-intercept represent in the graph? Well, it's going to be the initial cost of renting the boat, just from looking at this. If we're going to be running a boat per hour, you're going to pay an initial cost. Which of the following represents the represents the relationship between H and C? Well, C is the cost. And H is the hours, and this is a line. The 5 is the initial, so C is equal to every hour it's increasing by 2 or 3. That's starting at 5, so it's every hour it's increasing by 3, which means it has a slope of 3, so 3 times H plus 5. Our answer is C. The complete graph of the function f is shown in the xy plane. For what value of x is the value f of x at its minimum? Well, that's going to be at negative 1, negative 2, negative 3. Right here is when we're at our minimum. So that's at x is equal to negative 3. In the xy plane, if 0, 0 is a solution to the system of inequalities above, which is the following relationship between a and b? What must it be? Y, 0, 0, 0 is less than or equal to 0 plus a. Well, a must be positive. Then 0 is greater than 0 plus b. B must be negative. Since a must be positive and b must be negative, a has to be greater than b. Okay, a food truck sells salad for $6.50 each and drinks for $2 each. 209 salads and drinks in one day was 836. How many salads were sold that day? So we're going to put salads as S and drinks as D. And they gained 836.50 from one day. They sold S plus D is equal to 209. S is equal to 209 minus D. Well, let's do this the other way around. It'll get this number faster. D is equal to 209 minus S. We have 6.5s plus 209 minus s is equal to 836.50. 6.5s minus 2s after we distribute it plus 418. 836.5 minus 418. Nope, wrong number. 836.5 minus 418, not 481, is 418.5. And then we have 4.5s is equal to 418.5. We divide 418.5 by 4.5, and we get 93. I hope that is the right answer. Next page. I'm about a laptop computer at a store that gave 20% discount off its original price. So it's 0.8 to get the original. 0.8 times L is how much the subsequent is. The total amount she paid to the cashier was $P. And then, no, we can't do that. Oh gosh, I'm losing time. It's not A, and I doubt it's B. The original price, I'm gonna say is D. If that's wrong, I'll take the hit. Dreams recalled during 1 week. The data in the table above were produced by sleep researchers studying the number of dreams people recall when asked to record their dreams for 1 week. Group X experience consisted of 100 people who researched early bedtimes, chosen at random from those who recalled at least one dream. What is the probability that belonged to group Y? They recalled one dream, at least one dream. So it's both, it's this category here. If a person at random is chosen from this group here, what is the probability they were a part of Y? Well, that's the total of these two groups, which is 39 plus 125, which is 164. And then the sum of 11 plus 68, which is 79. That's C. Let me look at 20 one more time. You have 20% discount off the original price. The total amount she paid was P. She paid 8% sales tax on the discounted price. 0.8 out of both. I'm just going to stick with my answer. I don't have too much time to lose. Okay, annual budgets. Which of the following best approximates the average rate of change in the annual budget for agricultural natural resources in Kansas from 2008 to 2010? Okay, we're looking at this. We're looking from 2008 to 2010. Well, to find the approximate change, let's take the final, 488106, subtract the initial, 358708, and then divide by the number of years, which is 2. We have about 65,000. Of the following, which program's ratio of 2007 budget to its 2010 budget is the closest to the human resources program's ratio of 2007 to 2010? Okay, so to find this ratio, let's divide the 2010 date by the 2008 date of human resources. So that's 5921379. And public safety, 464233 divided by 398326. Oh, 2007 to 2010. No, this is awful for my time. HR is 5921379. Divided by 4051050. It's still 1.46. At 1.46 for HR. So we're looking for something that took half of the original and then added to it. Public safety is a good candidate. 464233 divided by 262463. That's actually a huge increase. 464233. 263463, 1.76. 488106 divided by 373904, 1.305. Education is 3008036 divided by 2164607. It's a 1.389. That's the closest one so far. And then highways is 1773893 divided by 1468482. That's 1.2. So we're gonna go with education. It's the closest number we have. Okay, next page. Which of the following is an equation of a circle in the x-y plane with a center 0, 4 and a radius and point of 4.3, 5. 0, 4, we know the y needs to be -4, so it's gonna be y -4. It's not this one or this one. Okay, and then a center radius. Endpoint 4 over 3, 5. So if we plug in 4 over 3 for x, 4 over 3 squared plus 5 minus 4. That's going to be 1 squared is going to equal to, what will that equal? That's going to be 9 over, that's going to be 16, come on, 16 over 9 plus 1. Or 16 plus 9 over 9, 25 over 9. Our answer is A. So 26. Katrina is a botanist studying the production of pears by two types of pear trees. She noticed that type A produced 20% more based than B. Based on Katrina's observation, type A produced 144. How many did B produce? Well, A produces 20% more, so 144 is equal to 1.2 times B. So we divide 144 by 1.2. We get 120. The equation above expresses the approximate height in meters of a ball t seconds after it launched vertically upward from the ground with an initial velocity of 25 meters per second. It's approximately how many seconds will the ball hit the ground? So when is this going to equal to zero? When is the height equal to zero? Is equal to negative 4.9 t squared plus 25 t. Gosh. Okay. We can pull out negative 4.9 from both. We're in negative 4.9t. And that's t 25 divided by negative 4.9 is 5.102. t is equal to 0 or positive 5.102 or d. A square field measures 10 by 10 meters, 10 students each mark off randomly, blah, 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 blah. Not really actually useful. Which of the following is a reasonable approximation of the number of earthworms? Where did earthworms come from? Okay, so we're randomly selecting 5 out of 100, and we're going to take the average of, oh, there's actually 10. So we're going to take the average of this, and then average of every region, and then we're going to multiply it by 100. So 107 plus 147 plus 146. The reason this works is because each region is going to be an approximation, and by taking their average, we can get like the approximate region amount. So it's about 147.1 per region, which seems about right. We're going to multiply this by 100, and we get 14,710, which is C. Hey, this is future me again. I actually got this entire page wrong, so I'm going to skip it and add 3 points to the penalty. Why can husk at least 12 dozen ears of corn per hour and at most 18 dozen ears of corn per hour? So between that, based on this information, what is the possible amount of time and hours that it would take Wyatt to husk 72 ears of corn? What is a possible? It's about 15. 72 divided by 15. 4.8. The posted weight limit for covered wooden bridge in Pennsylvania. Forgot to do the counter. Oops. Okay, yeah. The posted weight limit for wooden bridge in Pennsylvania is 14 pounds. Pass over the bridge. The combined weight of the trunk and its driver is 4,500 pounds. What is the maximum possible weight? Okay, so we have 6,000 is our limit. We have 14x per box, and we want to see what is the most we can, most amount of boxes we can have. So first we subtract from 6,000, 4,500, and we divide that by 14. 6,000 minus 4,500, divide by 14, and we get about 107, because we can't really get a 0.1 of a box. According to the line graph above, the number of portable media players sold in 2008 is what fraction of the number sold in 2011? So it's 100 in 2011, it is 160. 100 compared to 160 is 10 over 16, 5 over 8. A local television station sells time slots for programs in 30 minutes intervals. If the station operates 24 hours a day, every day of the week, what is the total number of 30-minute time slots can sell for Tuesday and Wednesday? So, how many there are 48 hours on Tuesday and Wednesday combined, times 2 for every 30-minute slot is 96 total 30-minute slots. Final page, let's go. A dairy farmer uses a storage silo that is in the shape of the right cylinder above. If the volume of the silo is 72 pi cubic yards, what is the diameter of the base? Okay. Volume of a cylinder is a circle times height. So it's height times area of a circle is pi r squared. We know it's 72 pi is equal to 8 times pi r squared. 72 divided by 8 pi is 72 divided by 8 is 9. So r squared is equal to 9. R is equal to 3. However, diameter is equal to 2r, so 6. For what value of x is the function h above undefined? It's going to be undefined when we have 0 on the bottom. So what gets us 0 here? We have to get a negative number somehow. If we plug in 5, it won't be enough because we're going to end up with 1 over 4. What if we need to get the 4x minus 5 to be a significant negative number. What if we plug in 4, this will become negative 1, and so thus negative 4. But that doesn't get us rid of the front variable. What about 2? Or 3? 4 times 3 minus 5 is negative 8. X minus 5 would be negative 2. Negative 2 squared is 4. So this would be 4 minus 8 plus 4. So it's when x is equal to 3. Last two questions. Jessica opened a bank account that earns 2% interest compounded annually. Her initial deposit was $100, and she uses the expression 100x to the t to find the value of her account. What is the value of x in the expression? Oh, x is 1.02. That's how much it's increasing every year with interest. Jessica's friend Taishuan found an account that earns 2.5% interest compounded annually. Taishuan made her initial deposit of 100 into the account. At the same time, Jessica, after 10 years, how much more money will Taishuan's initial amount have earned than Jessica's initial amount? Okay, so Jessica has 100 times 1.02 to the 10. Taishuan has 100, 1.025. This compounds annually? Yes, okay, 1.025 to the 10. So we're gonna find the difference in these two numbers. 1.02 to the 10 times 100 is 121.899. 1.025 to the 10 times 100 is 128.0084. The lesson to learn here is to never trust banks. They will always screw you out of your money. So 128, let's just do the calculator subtraction here. 128.0084. This is an awful account. Only 2%. It's 6.10. Answer to the nearest cent and ignore the dollar sign. So we're gonna do 6.11. And that's time. Oh my gosh. Much more exhausting than doing it in person, that's for sure. But it's over. Now time to see how I actually did. So I finished with 32 minutes and 47 seconds, but I had a penalty of 4 because I got 4 questions wrong. So it's about 36 minutes in total, which I think it's pretty good for a 55-minute portion of the exam and 38 questions. But I definitely have to practice those questions I got wrong so that next time I can do even better. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this, please let me know, and I will consider doing it again. Have a wonderful day.